Now, the introduction of the threshing machines. The Napoleonic Wars made the prices to go up. Simultaneously, the production has increased larger and larger. So, production started to increase higher and higher because the Napoleonic Wars were at an peaks. So, the prices now are shooting up like at any level. So, randomly the prices went on to very high level. Now, with the fear of the shortage of the labor, the rich landlords now started to purchase the newly introduced machine in the market, that is the threshing machine. This machine will do lot of work. They help them in the field. The shortage of the labor can be overcome, and they also started to give complaints that saying they have insolence in the labor. They have the drinking habits. It's very difficult to make them to work. So we cannot make them to work. We cannot force them to work. They doesn't work willingly. So all these reasons made them to buy the new machine, the threshing machine, which is available in the market at that point of time. With this, the situation, it has become very difficult for the farmers or the poor people to find jobs. And simultaneously along with this, after the Napoleonic Wars came to end, the soldiers who were busy in the war now returned back to the villages, and now they need some alternative jobs to do. So in this process of searching the alternative jobs, the number of the unemployed people started to grow larger and larger in number. And with this, the trade also between Europe and England started to restart. So with the restart of the trade, the price of the grains came down rapidly. When the price of the grains came down, again the rich landlords want to maintain that stability of economy. So they started to reduce the land production area, and they started to pressurize the government to put bans on the import of the grains and all these things. Somehow they could not manage all these things. The agricultural depression has set in. They could not stop the imports of the grain, and finally resulting in everybody started to feel that the labor, that because of the threshing machines only, their life has become worst in the situations. So now, having to the conclusion, why did they object the threshing machines so much? Earlier, they used to have open fields where they used to have the customary rights. They used to collect the firewood. They used to graze their animals. They used to pasture their cattle. Then they used to bring or collect the fruits, berries. They used to hunt the animals like rabbits, small animals. They used to do fishing in the rivers and the ponds and everything. Now, these all started to disappear. They are finding very difficult to find even a job. And that job was also highly insecure. The wages are very low. Those are fixed and seasonal. So it has become very difficult for them to find any job, and they were thrown into the clutches of unstable income groups. Maybe this is the main reason why the people hated the threshing machines so much. This is the story behind why the people in England hated the threshing machines and burned them into ashes, because they are worried about their future. They believed that the future was completely destroyed after these machines were brought into place. Now, moving on to understand bread basket and the dust bowl. How did Let's Cross travel through Atlanta of United States? How did USA turn as the bread baskets of the world? Earlier, when we compare with the England's changes in the 16th century to 18th century, in USA, we don't have that much changes happening. It was completely covered with forest around for 800 million acres and grasslands for 600 million acres. So it is completely covered and there is no much agricultural practice going on there. Then how did it get converted into the bread baskets of the world? That is the main agenda what we are going to discuss now. So by 1780s, the white Americans were restricting themselves only to the coastal strip on the eastern side. They used to stay on the coastal strip region, and the native Americans are basically nomadic people. Most of them, they live in groups and some of them are settled. So these people, the nomadic people, used to do the occupations like hunting, gathering and fishing. They also used to do the cultivation of the crops like corn, bean, tobacco and pumpkin. Along with this, they are famous for their trapping skills. They used to trap. they are the excellent trappers, and they used to do the beaver's fur. They used to export this to the England people for many centuries. Now moving on to the new changes which happened in USA was the people, the white people who used to restrict themselves to the coastal regions started to move towards the west and displace the original Native Americans from there. So with the displacement of them, the changes started to occur. These whites occupied the lands there and converted them into the agricultural vast regions. So what happened? Why did these people move from the coastal areas towards the western side? What happened to the local people at that time? How did they react? These all we will discuss now. Now moving on into the details. Why did the Americans move from the eastern coast to the western side? It was during the war period, American War of Independence, that was fought from 1775 to 1783. After the war was completed, now Thomas Jefferson became the president in 1800. So the 7 lakh Americans looked at the West as a land of promise. Why it is looked as a land of promise towards the West? It has been wilded. It has been filled with forests. It has mountains. It has lot of forest animals or wild animals living there. The forest, it has huge reserves of timber. The timber can be exported. Cut the trees and export the timber. Do mining, gold and mineral mining in the mountain ranges. And at the same time, hunt the animals. Sell the hides and the parts of the animals. So like this, it looked as a land of promise for the Americans, which also meant that the local native Indians have to be displaced. Yes, the settled Indians in America have to be displaced from there. Then only the Americans can fulfill all the dreams of land of promise towards the West. The government headed by Thomas Jefferson also was committed to this, to weed out the Indians from there towards the West and from there still further towards the West. So these 7 lakh people of white Americans were moved towards the Appalachian Plateau, from where the initial war started between the Indians and the whites. Number of wars were waged. They were numerous. Indians also gave a firm resistance for that. They won some battles. They were burnt alive. They were destroyed. Then they also displaced many of them. Like this, many of them were massacred. After all these incidents, finally, the Indians have to surrender. They have to move towards the west near the Mississippi region and further west again. In the process of doing cultivation, after cutting down the crops, they have slashed, they have burnt everything, and they started to cultivate the large lands. First they have sown this corn and then wheat. In the initial years, they have got good profits because they yielded good results. But after a couple of years, the soil lost its fertility. Then they start to find out the new lands, and they used to explore the new lands and further move westwards and still westwards. Finally, only in 1860s, they were able to move to the region of Great Plains in the Mississippi region or around the Mississippi River region, where the most fertile bit of America lies. Then it started to dominate the entire world in the production of bread for many years, especially for wheat. So that's how the main momentum of the whites went towards the western side. Now let's follow into the details of this lesson little bit more in detail.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.